Hello, I'm Mike. In today's video, I shall demonstrate the way on how to create and use Power BI Q&A visual to explore data in Power BI. As mentioned in Microsoft Docs sites, that Power BI report user can use the visual to quickly get answer to their data, and the Power BI report designers can also use it to create visual quickly. In screen, I have a Power BI desktop loaded with Microsoft Power BI sample data, opportunity analysis sample. To understand the sample data and how to download the PBIX file, you may refer to the URL link I attached in below video description. If you have a Power BI Pro or Premium per user PPU license, you may also able to connect the sample data set directly from Power BI service and your workspace. In desktop file, we have four report pages, which describes sales opportunity counts overview, revenue overview, upcoming opportunity overview, region opportunity overview, for example, by size, sales stage, partner driven, region, and month period. The additional page info is about sample data provider, obvious, and how to use the data. By the data view, we see six tables. Except the fact table, the other five tables are dimension tables. We may check through this table name, column name, and the measure name quickly by following Microsoft guides of Q&A best practice, how to optimize data and models for best Q&A, such as more accuracy and natural naming for table, column, and measure, write data type for each column and measure, and mark year and identifiers column as don't summarize. Choose a data category for each date and geography column, etc. By the model view, we see a star schema data model structure with all necessary activity relationship links between dimension tables and fact table. We may also find which tables has created columns and measures. For example, under fact table, we have about five created columns and six created measures. For having optimized model for Q&A ready, Microsoft best Q&A guides also list a few important checking criteria, such as how to normalize your model by creating new tables for multi-column entity, pivoting to animated property bags, splitting format columns, etc., and denormalizing model to animate the inactive relationship, etc. For details, please refer to the Microsoft Docs about Power BI Q&A best practice, which the URL link I have attached in below video description. With this quick check through on the sample data tables and model, we are okay to process the Q&A visual creations in the report. For report consume users, we have two ways to present our created Q&A visuals and service site. One is from a report page, another one is from dashboard. Let's get started first to create the Q&A visuals and report page from desktop file, and then publish it to the service side. In report and report view, let me make a theme changing to the report. And the report view on the top ribbon, choose the view tab, then from the themes drop-down list, choose the dark theme and apply it. Click the plus sign on the bottom to create the new page and give names as Q&A explores data. Move the pager to the left front position. On the right-hand side, show the visualization panel. Choose and click the Q&A visual. The Q&A visuals appears in the report pager. Adjust the visual size and fit it with the pager size. We see the visual has four components. One is a question box. This is where users type in their question and are shown suggestions to help them complete their questions. The second component is a pre-populated list of suggested questions by Power BI to give user hints on how to make questions. Third and fourth components are the icons, by which one is to convert the Q&A visual into a standard visual. Another one is to open Q&A tooling that allows designers to configure the underlying natural language engine. In the section of the suggested question, choose and click one suggested question. For example, question of what is revenue by month. Then we see Power BI draws a cluster column chart for us. The x-axis is months from the January to December. Y-axis is the revenue value. In the question box to the end of the question, if we added space or additionally by and space, then Power BI suggests a variable dimension list as additionally cluster options to resolve chart. For example, let's select a meaningful cluster sales stage. Then we see an updated enhanced column chart. Further to the end of the question, if we added space and as and space, then Power BI suggests a variable type of chart to revisualize the data. For example, choose the suggested matrix, then a matrix table appears as the updated visual. Let's resort the month column, expanded the plus sign under the January. We see three splitted rows corresponding to the three sales stages. With the Q&A, report consumed users can explore data by making their own questions. Report designer can also create the visual into report pager by converting their satisfied Q&A generated visuals. For example, if you are the owner or have the access to the dataset, in the right top corner, click the dot converted icon. The Q&A result can be turned into the standard visuals in report. I shall demonstrate the steps later in the video. This is the way on how to create and use Q&A visual in report pager. If we publish it to the service, and users will have the Q&A pages to explore data as the view from the desktop file. As before mentioned, the second way to use Q&A feature is from the dashboard and service side. Let me clean the question in Q&A report pager, save and publish it to the service workspace, Power BI features, simulation and demo. On the Power BI service side, go to the workspace Power BI features, simulation and demo. Click the report opportunity analysis sample for YouTube demo. Let's create a new dashboard by pinning some visuals from the report. Say in opportunity count page, let's click the visual opportunity count by region. On top, click the pin visual icon. In the pop-up window, use the destination theme for Thai theming. Click new dashboard. Name the dashboard as Opportunity Overview. Then visual appears in the new created dashboard. On the top of the dashboard, we may find the dialog box with Q&A icon to ask a question about your data. This is the place for consume users to make questions. Let's ping four more visuals from Opportunity Count pages, Revenue Overview pages, and upcoming opportunity pages. Now let's click the Q&A dialog box on top of the dashboard. Power BI brings us to a new page. Here we have the same view as Q&A visual in report page, but without converting icon and gears icon in right top, which are visible only to the report designers. Make a question which is not showing in the suggest list. Say, top opportunity name by factored product revenue. In the end, and the by sales stage name. And as table to draw the visual. In the end, and by region. And by segment, and by partner driven, and by partner name. Then we have the all related info in table format to the identified top opportunity name by factored product revenue. This is the way by which users can get answers to data from dashboard Q&A. We have mentioned before that report designers can also utilize the Q&A visual in report pager to make visuals and Power BI service side. Let's go to the workspace and open the report opportunity analysis sample for YouTube demo. Select the report pager Q&A exposure data. On the top ribbon, click the edit icon, click show all suggestions, click one suggestion. What is factored revenue by segment? And the space as. Expand show more, choose column chart. On the top right corner, click the icon to turn the result into standard visual. Adjust the position and size of the visual. Let's make another visual in the pager. Click any empty place in the pager. In the right-hand side, the visualization panel, click the Q&A visual. In the pop-up new Q&A visual, type question, show top opportunity name, by revenue as table, then by product code, by region, by sales stage, by partner, then click the convert icon, make up the visual by moving the column opportunity name to the left front position. Adjust the visual position and size. Then on top left file menu to click save options to save this report. By now, I have demonstrated the steps on how to create the Q&A visual in desktop and use the Q&A visual to make questions to data and get answers from Power BI. Also show the method how to create the Q&A visuals in Power BI dashboard and service side. Lastly, I introduced the V for report designers on how to create standard visuals via the Q&A visual in report pager and service side. In coming videos, I shall share you the V's on how to improve the Q&A visual user experience, such as how to train Q&A to understand natural language questions and terms it has not recognized, how to create the featured question and the dataset level, which gives the users idea about what type of question they can ask about their dataset, etc. Thanks for your watching. If you want to watch more videos from my channel, please press subscribe button in below. See you in next video.